At ringside, here is the world TV champion, Arn Anderson.
Maybe Emmanuel Fernandez would like to try that maneuver on me sometimes on his run. I'm sure he would. The Great American Bash, the greatest sporting event ever in the history of any promotion, is coming all throughout this country in the upcoming months. Right or wrong, Tony Schiavone?
Right.
And one of the topics of the world television title. I don't care who it is, I want top contenders when I'm in an arena with 25 or 50,000 people, because Tony Schiavone, I base my credibility on one thing. That's defending this against the top competitors in the world today. And as you see, I do it week in and week out right on this television. Right or wrong?
Right.
That's
right.
The reason when I tell you something is going to happen. And I've been talking about all along the four horsemen. Not three, I'm talking about four horsemen, and you know who that is. That's my cousin Ole Anderson, a man that taught me quite a bit about tag team wrestling and one thing alone about being a man. So Dusty Rhodes, when you and those 300-pound Road Warriors did what you did, and you know what I'm talking about, I told you there would be a rebuttal. So somewhere in this great land, at the time of our choosing, Ole Anderson will show back up. You can bank on that.
Back right after this timeout. Now the Rock and Roll Express are the hands of the world heavyweight champion, Nature Boy Ric Flair. We're going to take a look at that. Fans, you're not really going to like what you're going to be seeing, but we need to take a look at this right now. Let's go to that tape. David,
our match. Watch Ricky Morton. He has... Watch the referee out. Now watch it. He goes down for that pin. Now you count it. He has the man beaten right there.
Ricky Morton, it's obvious the man can stay right in the ring with a heavyweight champion of the world. He has proved that time and time again.
Here they come.
How many times have we seen this?
So many times. All right, Arn Anderson, Tully Blanchard, J.J. Dillon comes in. They start to stomp away on him. They did this one time before. They rubbed his face in the concrete. Now they take him.
And there's nothing a man can do, regardless how good athlete you are, when there's a four-on-one.
Look at Ric Flair. He takes his time, gets his position. Plops the knee right across the head. Puts his face right down the mat, breaks his nose. That's not it. That's
shatters
not
his nose, but Ric Flair was not finished right there. He was not satisfied with just breaking the nose. He wanted to injure the man even further. And fans, take a look at this tape. This happened just right after what you saw happen to Ricky Morton. Dave, we're going to take a look at slow motion. Watch the knee and watch the head of Ricky Morton.
Look at the head bounce, just like a ball. Again, shattering that nose.
Shattering the nose of Ricky Morton of the Rock and Roll Express. Dusty Rhodes comes in, and Ricky, obviously this is not the situation you want to be in, but it's good to see you and Robert out here.
Tony, let me tell you something. It's all started right here. Ric Flair, you come out here on TV, brother, you try to put us down. You put the nice people down, and I'll put you in your place. Now, what gets him down, Tony, is a point of jealousy, because you know you can't beat the Rock and Roll Express no time, any place, or anywhere. So you thought by coming out, getting Arn Anderson, Tully Blanchard, and J.J. Dillon, not breaking my nose, Tony, but crushing it, that it's going to stop us? No way, brother. You're not going to stop us, Flair. But you see right here, I got two of them, specially made, brother, to step right back in the ring. You might crush my nose, brother, but my nose is a long way from my heart. And I'm going to prove to you, because the way I was brought up, baby, it's an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. And we're going to sell it that way. Woo!
The Rock and Roll Express will take this brief timeout and be right back.